Get ready to match the stars from Chips, Robert Pine, Brett Summers, Charles Dustin Riley, Stephanie Edwards, Bill Daly, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Ritter.
Hi, John. Hello, friends. Thank you for joining us here. Everybody ready?
Ready, go. Let's go, Matt. Oh, good.
In case you need one, there's a spare ball for you.
Who lost this one?
No, that's...
I have two of them now.
Yes, that's right.
Two balls.
Bill's been sabotaging my chair.
Can you hear me now from this? Okay?
Yeah.
Just have to speak louder.
That's right.
Okay, let's play this game.
Oh, wait a minute. Was, something's wrong. Would you stand up for a second, please?
He fixed it so that I would fall over into his lap.
Are you nice and tall?
Yeah. Nice and tall, too.
Are you pretty girl? Na da 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 da
da da da da da da da. Few of us my age can still foxtrot.
Well, maybe you were that.
Gee, you must be filling
some. No, not. Cut! Did we fix it?
A lot of maroon going on. Yes.
What's wrong with your chair?
Fix her seat. I'll fix her seat.
No.
No, her seat is all right.
Oh, she's got a nice seat.
Yes. Is it too low or too high?
It's just fine. He had balanced it so that I would fall into his lap, but I kind of have adjusted to it. Now, if I hold my shoulder like this, I'm fine.
Out of touching. Hospital dance.
Touching show.
Take with you to New
Weren't
York, Charles.
Weren't our patients wonderful in our lovely dance section?
Let's say hello to our two players over here, Bill Morris and Sandra Minogian. Bill is an ex-cop who now is into athletics of all kinds, but weightlifting mostly.
Yes, we're a racquetball, tennis ball club, and health
Oh, you work there and you teach people how to do this.
Yes,
I see.
Yes.
You play racquetball?
Just beginning to learn.
Yeah. It's a hard game, isn't it? It's very fast. It's like squash, isn't it?
It's very fast, but there's different levels to it that people don't understand until they really get into it.
All right. Now, and this lady has beautiful brown eyes. That's what we all decided. Yes. Now, refresh our memories about you, please, Sandra. Oh,
okay. I'm the one, third generation Armenian.
Third generation Armenian.
Had a degree in dairy science.
She worked
what?
With cows.
Degree in dairy science.
Dairy science.
Dairy science.
That's right. Now, what school did you get that from?
Pierce.
Pierce. Is that the school?
In this area, it is.
It is.
We have
Are
a
you
going to
practice that?
No, I was shoeing horses for a while, and now I'm just assisting a veterinarian.
Well, you're going to do it. All right, here we go. We're in game one, right?
Shoeing horses.
And we're in the middle of round two, and the score is 5-0, and that means, Bill, you got to get on your horse here and
yes,
get going.
Yes, sir, sure do.
Well, then,
5-0,
Bill,
6-0. Here we go. Sid said, I got the world's toughest banker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Last time I asked for a loan, he wanted my blank for collateral.
I know.
You know when?
Yes?
You know when you're too heavy?
No. How do you know when you're too heavy?
When the crotch on your calf tin is too tight.
What do you say?
Never mind, honey. You're better off not knowing. Trust me.
When the crotch on your calf tin is too tight?
Then you want to go
He's
to
going
New York
soon.
With him.
He's going to New York soon. He'll be gone a long enough time for us to regain our sanity, and then he'll return.
I strongly
He's
doubt
He's going to
that.
Do a Broadway show called Charlotte about Goethe. There's a neighborhood in Chicago where they have a street that's named G-O-E-T-H-E, and the local people there call it Goethe Street.
Goethe.
Goethe, yes. Bill. Sid said, I've got the world's toughest banker. Last time I asked for a loan, he wanted my blank for collateral.
We'll try wife.
Good wife is all right. All right, that's a good one. He said wife. What do you say to that?
Well, I'm really learning to play this game.
You are.
Wife.
Robert.
Wife.
Wife.
Yeah. Smart cop.
That's two.
Two.
That's
right.
Two in all the times he's done this bloody show.
You know, the only time he's matched, you'll come to think of it, is when he's playing with a cop.
Playing with a cop.
Two
right.
cops there.
Match that cop.
Right. Match that cop.
That's
a good show. Let's just put that thing
together.
We got a title. All we got to do is find out how to do it. What do you say?
Well, how do you think poor Fannie feels? And you're talking about him being in Charlotte. She's going to do a play, too. She's going to do a play called Come Back to the Dime, Five and Dime, Jimmy Dean, Jimmy Dean.
Yeah, she's gonna do that.
She's all upset. You never invited me.
Between you and Gene and your plugs, you're killing both plays. You
know? And I didn't even have the right answer after all that. Blood, all of it.
I've got the world's toughest banker. Last time I asked for a loan, he wanted my blood for collateral.
Blood is what I did.
All right, so that means Sandra wins the game. What do you have there? Blood, white, tell a couple of white. And we'll say goodbye to Bill Morris, but only for a little while.
All right.
We're going to spin you around, come back later to play game number two.
Okay.
Okay, Bill? All right. You ready? Okay. Here we go.
All right.
Where are we going?
With her. Anywhere she wants to go.
All right,
Take me with you, Sandra. I don't know.
No, let's have a go at this, Sandra. We polled the studio audience and said write down your best answer to this. Captain Blank. Captain Blank. Now, if you match the answer they gave most often, you get $500. Now, if you give us the answer they wrote down second most often, you get $250. And then for matching the third most popular answer, $100. And three of the six ding-a-lings will help, but call on the ones who have an intelligent... Step out his side here a little bit.
Intelligent.
Call on the ones that have a smart look on their face. The other dummies don't have an answer.
No, we'll try, Bill.
We warned
Bill.
You, Sandra. Bill.
That was my...
She's
did you
returning.
Think that was my bright look?
She's returning.
Sorry, my bright look. I'm like this.
All right. That was your bright look.
Oh, gosh. My bright look is this. The same look that I have.
Yeah.
Captain, right? Captain Bly.
Captain Bly.
I know you hated that, but
that's
I didn't know what to
it
say.
That's stinks.
Right. She has two other chances. It's all right.
Okay, Stephanie.
But thank you for picking him, because I like you, too.
Fanny? Did you say Stephanie? Stephanie. I'm sorry.
The apostrophe is what's important here.
Yeah.
So it would have to be Captain Andy.
Captain Andy.
Mm, from Showboat, I think, isn't it?
Mm. Right.
And Charles?
The audience loves our answers. So.
Boy,
Wait a minute. You didn't like that?
You didn't come up with a winner, sweetheart.
Well, but you know why you picked.
Dumb.
Absolutely.
Well, there's a lot of good ones. There's cap and gown, but I'm not going to go with that.
No, wait.
That was just a throwaway to test. Captain Kangaroo. That's
Captain Kangaroo.
Captain, can I give two for everyone because I'm leaving?
All right, now, here's the way it is. Captain Kangaroo, Captain Bly, and Captain Andy are the three they've given you. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own. Have you thought about it?
Cap and gown.
Now, listen, audience. Your enthusiastic reaction may be misleading.
That's true.
Yes,
are you sure
you
that's
going to
be up on top
say.
There? If it's not, you got to give her the $500. Lock the doors, Johnny. Johnny Oldham will lock the doors, and that's it. Let's see if we have Captain Gown up there someplace. May we see the $100 response?
Don't pay attention to that audience.
Yes, it was indeed up there. But in the lowest possible position. What's under the next one, please? Captain Crunch. What is that? Well, that's a cereal.
It's going to be Captain
No plugs,
kangaroo.
Please.
Yeah.
Kangaroo.
I think kangaroo would have to be up there, wouldn't you? Find out right now.
Kangaroo.
Yeah. Kangaroo it is, yeah. It's, you know, it's been on the air 30 years, and we all wake up early in the
Captain
morning and
kangaroo.
Watch it. And anyway, there it is. So, now, you hang around here because you still can win some more money. You've got $100, but we'll see if we can add to that, but not this for you. Here's the way it is, Sandra. You've won $100. Means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $1,000. Okay. However, you are going to spin the star wheel, and with a good lucky spin of the wheel, you'll double it up and play for $2,000, and we'll all wish you the best of luck. Step right up there, and we'll wish for, hope for a double here for Sandra Manoogian. Here we go. Big. You just slid by Robert Pine there for a double, but you're going to play with him, all right?
Okay.
Ready? Here we go.
Play with Robert.
Good luck to you. For $1,000, this is it. Blank flower. Or blank flower. Blank flower. Blank flower. F-L-O-W-E-R. F-L-O-W-E-R.
Perfect, sweetheart.
Just keep her around. Don't let I like her. Keep her around.
All right. Now, Robert's finished. Now, Sandra, if you give us the same answer he has in the card, you'll get the $1,000. Now, this, to me, it seems like an easy one.
What You're not here.
All right.
You're over here. Wait, there you go.
Okay. Oh, very hard.
It is. Yeah.
Now, now that you're there, it's easy there.
Oh, it's much easier. How about pretty flower?
Oh. Wrong again.
Stand over there.
Did you ever see a homely one?
Robert, she said pretty flower. We'll match you for the
$1,000.
What would you have said, Mr.
Rayburn? Well, sunflower. Yeah, what
You would have said sunflower.
Sunflower is what I would have said.
Not necessarily. Yeah, right. We would have said cauliflower or wild.
Wildflower. Yeah. Audience, what would you have said? Wild.
You're wrong, Gene.
All right. Wildflower. Well, wildflower, there are all kinds of good ones. All right, Sandra, you're going to play another game, so let's bring your opponent right back right now and have a go at it. Here comes Bill Maher. There you go. Welcome back, Bill.
Thank you.
Well, Sandra stubbed her toe there, I'm sorry to say. She's got $100, which is not bad, but she could have done a lot better than that. Let's start game number two. This is the final game for the two of you, and Bill, you have a choice of A or B.
Well, I'll stick with A.
A it is.
Okay.
Ready? Here it is.
We're ready.
Tom, the traveling salesman, said, "This hotel is in a really tough neighborhood.
Oh, boy.
When I put a... one lonely voice in the wilderness crying, how tough is that?
Very anyway. Good. Don't get intimidated. That was excellent. And thank you for your spirit.
All right. If you really want to do it, I'll do it. You want to do it?
A really tough neighborhood.
Tom, the traveling salesman, said, "This hotel is in a really tough neighborhood."
How tough is it?
You're okay. Leave him in the cast. When I put a quarter in the magic fingers machine, they didn't massage me, they blanked me.
Juice. Don't light a match.
Tom, the traveling salesman, said, "This hotel is in a really tough neighborhood." When I put a quarter in the magic fingers machine, you're familiar with those things, aren't you?
Yes, sir.
You are.
They didn't massage me. They blanked me.
Robbed me.
Robbed me. Magic fingers robbed him instead of massaging him. Bob?
Yeah, well, I think punched would be the right
punched
one.
Punched would be another thing.
There is no right or wrong in this game,
round
mister.
One question, and you can, anything
I
you want
said,
here.
I said, well, of course, what we always say. I said frisked and robbed.
Frisked and robbed, so there's one for him.
There you go, Bill.
Okay.
When was our big earthquake here, 71? Was
that yes, the, 71.
The funny stories that came out of it, one was a man put a quarter in the bed, you know, and it started to shake, and then the whole thing shook, and he ran out in the street and said, "It's me, it's my fault, I caused it, I, me." These stories will all come out in Inside Los Angeles. Pickpocketed me.
Pickpocketed me.
Isn't that a match?
That's a match.
Holy mackerel, yeah.
Oh, good.
What do you say?
That's two lapses in 1 week. That's
a
lot more than
I could tell you plenty of stories, inside stories about the director and about the producer, but
please don't.
I'll just quietly go to New York with all of this in my heart and on my mind.
He's in a real
funk. I know it was the one, but I tried.
The minus one.
The hotel in a really tough neighborhood, when I put a quarter of the magic fingers machine, they didn't massage me, they blanked me.
This will work too, I'm just certain. Mugged will work.
Mugged. All right.
No. Huh? Good.
Yeah.
Good. Good.
Got another mug here. Got another mug.
All right, Fannie.
Well, I was thinking, since you were an ex-officer of the law, you perhaps your mind would wander to frisk, but it didn't.
Yes.
Sorry.
Frisk, right. You ever frisk anybody?
Yes.
I was frisked a couple of times.
Let me show you how we do it here.
Yes, frisk her. Yes. Frisk that girl.
All right, so it's four for him, none for you, but you have a round one question coming up in a moment or so right now. This one. All right, now, this is yours, Sandra. Listen carefully now. Are you all ready?
Ready.
Ready.
Sure, honey.
The old philosopher said... Show me a man who keeps his nose to the grindstone, and I'll show you a man who'll never look like blank. Got it, Bill? All right, son. The old philosopher said, show me a man who keeps his nose to the grindstone, and I'll show you a man who'll never look like blank.
Ooh, there's two good ones. I'm gonna go with Jimmy Durante.
That's one good one. What was the other good one?
Pinocchio.
Pinocchio was the other good one. Kid's getting very smart. Well, Jimmy Durante's her choice. Three good ones. Yeah, there is one more.
He's got one rotten one.
Oh, no. John Barrymore.
John Barrymore.
Had a profile.
He was famous for his nose.
But not a big nose.
But he really didn't have a big nose, did he?
He had a beautiful nose.
Yes.
Now, did you ever have the feeling that you wanted to go, that you wanted to stay, but you wanted to go? Jimmy Durante.
Mom's May Blake. She's fabulous. Gosh.
Who will be with you when I'm far away? When I'm far away from you?
Oh, the great Durante.
All right, that's two. Show me a man who keeps nose in the grindstone. Show me a man who'll never look like.
Mount Rushmore. There's a deeply philosophical reason behind this, and I'll explain it to you at another time.
Write us a letter.
Right.
You couldn't think of Durante. You couldn't think of Pinocchio.
I'm very young.
Now you're going to be sorry you didn't talk to me before the show. Jimmy Durante.
All right, Miss Fannie.
If you're away from home and your checks are lost or stolen, what will you do? What will you do?
All right, let's go to round two. Bill, you're ahead. We'll ask you to go first.
A again, please.
A it is. Robert Pine plays...
And Francis Flagg...
Francis Flagg will be the other. You ready? Here we go. Sarah said, this church must...
Oh, you got those feet down. Honey, you're going to faint if you leave them up there another minute.
Sarah said, this church must be run by a doctor. Instead of a plate, they're passing a blank. Got it?
Can we have that again?
Sarah said this church must be run by a doctor. Instead of a plate, they're passing a blank.
Good.
Live in the neighborhood?
No, not too.
Oh, all right. Sarah said this church must be run by a doctor. Instead of a plate, they're passing a blank.
Bedpan.
Good. We got it. That is the answer.
I'm only going to play on this show if you have cops as contestants.
There it is.
Obviously, the only thing you want to do.
He said bedpan. He's up to five now.
I understand that. And I said bedpan.
He's up to six. All right. When we come back from this commercial, you'll have your work cut out for you. You'll need three to tie, and that's the best you can do. Right now, this for you. Here we are. Well, there we are. There you have it. That's it, friends.
That's all.
Sandra and Bill, we'll see you next time we all get together, whenever that is. And we'll look forward to seeing you pan slowly as I walk. Thank you very much.
Very good, excellent.
And don't forget to watch him on Chips. That's Robert Pine.
Saturday night, 8 o'clock.
Saturday night, 8 o'clock. Okay.
Watch me on the religious sign-offs. I'll be there.
Religious sign-offs, right. Anything else? He's sitting far away because he's practicing leaving. He'll be going to Broadway soon, and we'll miss him, but he'll be back in a short while.
I must return to the theater, Jean.
Yes, to renew yourself. Right.
His first love, you know. Oh,
yes, of course.
All of that.
I'm Gene Rayburn. Join us next time for the Match Game.
Ah, the theater.
Well, what a rogue and peasant slave
all
am I.
All the players that I had seen. What the?
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.